We begin our second session. In first session, we looked at the introductory aspect of the study, and we looked at issues that relate to meaning of statistics. We looked at concept in statistics, and we looked at sources of data in statistics. We only looked at some sources of data in Nigeria. In today's lesson, which is the session two of the study, we'll be looking at the various measuring instruments that can be used in statistics. And broadly, we have two major instruments that can be used in measuring statistics. And these instruments are descriptive and inferential statistics. Descriptive statistics involves explaining the property of data through the use of table, pictograph, chart, graphs. It is broken down into measures of central tendency, measures of variability or spread. The importance of characteristics of descriptive statistics is that population to be studied are included. Now, when we are talking about measures of central tendency, we use mode, media, and mean to measure our result. We equally have measure of variabilities. The measure of variabilities include the standard deviation or variance, the minimum and maximum variables, and the kurtosis and skewness. For example, the following scores represent the performance of statistics student in first examination, first semester examination. For instance, we have a result like this, having group A 20, having 20, group B having 30, group C having 40, and then group D having 10. We can use the knowledge of the inferential statistics to solve this particular problem by we total the score first, then we analyze the scores. We can use the measures of central tendency, which include mean, median, mode, to measure this type of data. Inferential statistics usually draw conclusions from a population of interest using information obtained from a sample. Therefore, statistics of inference especially has to do with measurement of chance or probability. As a matter of fact, inferential statistics begins from where descriptive statistics stops. Inferential statistics has to do with comparing variables with variables. That is, majorly we have two types of variables. We have the dependent variable and the independent variable. So the inferential statistics compares the relationship existing between the dependent variable and independent variables. For example, in a question that has to do with determining the opinions of Nigeria about foreign and locally made goods, we can use the inferential statistic in solving that problem. The first thing to be done is to draw up our assumptions, which we normally refer to as hypotheses. In drawing up our assumptions, we have two types of hypotheses that we are going to draw up. We have the null hypothesis And we have the alternative hypothesis. The null hypothesis is always stated in negative form, while the alternate hypothesis is always stated in positive form. Now, if we accept the null hypothesis, we must reject the alternate hypothesis. And if we accept the alternate hypothesis, we must reject the null hypothesis. For instance, on a question just like I mentioned before about the opinion of Nigeria on foreign and locally made goods, we can derive two forms of hypothesis there. We can make inference that Nigerians do not prefer foreign product to locally made goods. We can equally, with that one is the null hypothesis, because it has to do with negative inferential hypothesis. Then we can equally look at the second one, which says that Nigerians prefer foreign product to locally made goods. That is alternate hypothesis, because it is stated in a positive form. Now, in coming to the conclusion or drawing conclusion from this particular statement, we need to use some tools. There are some tools that can be used in inferential statistics to provide solution to the two hypotheses that have been stated above. We can use ANOVA. ANOVA is analysis of variance. We can use t-test. We can use chi-square analysis. We can use regression analysis to come up with our result. And after coming up with the result, we now draw a conclusion on whether to accept the alternate hypothesis or to accept the null hypothesis. Now, if the null hypothesis is accepted, then we must reject the alternate hypothesis. And if the alternate hypothesis is accepted, then we must reject the null hypothesis. Those are the procedures that can be used in inferential statistics. We only have types of inferential statistics. Inferential statistics can be divided into two major groups, which include deductive statistics and inductive statistics. Deductive statistics has to do with reasoning from general to particular, whereas inductive statistics has to do with reasoning from particular to general. The difference is this. The reason why we need to use this particular method of inferential statistics is because sometimes the population of study may be too large to be studied at a go. And number one, it may be costly to study the entire population, and it may involve the use of much energy and money to carry out such research. So as a result of that, there is need for us to use the knowledge of inductive and deductive reasoning in arriving at the solution to our problem. Inductive statistics is the process of drawing inference about the population from the sample. It is arguing from the specific to the general, that is, reason of cost, time factor, accuracy, and other constraints. We make a complete enumeration, that is, or census of the population, impossible. The alternative is to use the concept in probability to draw a sample from the population, obtaining estimate of the population parameters and test statement through the use of hypothesis about the parameters. At the end of the day, the result will be obtained, and then we'll be able to come up with a valid conclusion at the end of the day. We can equally use inductive statistics in arriving at conclusion. For example, we can generalize on a particular point of view based on the result obtained from the samples. And just like we were told earlier, there are different methods that we can use in determining our samples. We can use non-probability techniques And we can equally use probability techniques in determining our the samples to be used in a population in a way of as a way of reducing the population to a manageable proportion. Now, having differentiated the two concepts, that is the concept of inferential statistics and descriptive statistics, there are some questions we need to ask in this session. The questions are, what are the differences between the two methods? That is the method of inferential and descriptive statistics. When we meet in the next class, we go further in looking at the calculation aspect and other issues that may arise. Thank you.